she taught me self-control. What a person doing in a time of crisis. You say, if it was me, I would kill somebody, you say. And then I understood that the Torah can give us different way of thinking. And it became Chozer B'Tshuva. I said, this is my story. And this lady, she made me Chozer B'Tshuva. This, what we say by Dom Aharon. Unfortunately, with all our ego trips, we become so quickly upset. Something we don't like becomes so upset, which is against the will of Hashem. And the simple thing is to know we have to do what Hashem tasked us to do. And to the wives over here, after you got married to your husband, you have to understand that you have a few things that you have to do for your husband without questioning, without this, without all your Shulchan Aruch, without all your insecurities. Nobody asks you. Send them before the man. There are things that you have to do for your wife, and you should not put all your complex with your mothers and sisters and your grandparents and this to your wife. And you have to know the thing that you have to do and you're doing it. That's all. But if you start with egos, and unfortunately being exposed to the culture over here, that everything is ego over here, we are losing it. And ego trips is the prescription for destruction. Family destruction, people with themselves destructed, the idea of this is the will of Hashem, and we are going to make it better. In the boundaries of Torah. We are not decision makers. A few weeks ago before Pesach, they asked me to perform a wedding. A modern couple, they like me to perform their wedding. So we had a big argument. They told me that they have to exchange vows. He has to say how much. Yeah, and they exchange promises and they exchange rings and how much is nice and how much is good. So I told them statistically most of these exchanges are finishing in the courthouse. Mm-hmm. And the simple one that the husband gives a ring and the wife, she for the first day we teach her by Dom Aharon not to say nothing, just to say, just have to say nothing, just to to accept it, this is a certain process of being quiet. So in the wedding, Baruch Hashem, they were following me, but I saw that there's a certain... So I told them that we say, Arayat Mekudeshet Li Kedat Moshe V'Yisrael. Why Moshe Rabbeinu is doing it in the wedding? They say, Moshe V'Yisrael lived in the desert for 40 years, fighting every second day. But they were together. So I say, you're allowed to fight, you're allowed to argue, but you're together. This is Kedat Moshe v'Yisrael. This is why I put Moshe Rabbeinu over here. So it doesn't mean that when they say under the chuppah in their ceremonies, all the commitment that she's doing and he's going to do, it's meaningless. Because when you start with ego trips, you just think about yourself. Nothing beside yourself, everything is just you in the world. But Nadav Avihu, they have to come to Beit HaMikdash. There is no fire? No fire. We have to wait? We have to wait. Moshe Rabbeinu are the leaders? They are the leaders. You should not try to expedite things that do not exist. And you take one day at a time. So why I told you before that it's a problem with... Because Moshe Rabbeinu is pushing them to go from their slavery to a self-esteem. But when your self-esteem is secure and feel safe about yourself, it's wonderful. But when you try to become smarter than HaKadosh Baruch Hu, like even King Solomon, the smartest person in the history, you become a very dangerous person. Because there is en etzah ve'en tvuna keneged Hashem. This is our belief. We are Jewish people. This is what the Torah says. And Hashem is going to make our world as he wants to do it. You are a woman, You are a wife, you have to know your responsibilities. Not your Shulchan Aruch, your responsibilities. You are a husband, your responsibilities. Not because of your wife, not because of your husband, because Hashem asked you. Once I was in a shul of Rabbi Weiss, he said that a woman came and told me, Rabbi, you call me Ezer Kenegdo, I am my husband's helper, I am his partner, I'm not his helper. I am a partner, she's telling him. So we told her, are you more than God? She said, no. He said, God called himself Melech Ozer Umoshiach Umagen. Hashem called himself Melech Ozer. What Ozer in Hebrew mean? A helper. So if Hashem called himself a helper, it's difficult to go there and help her. He say, no, but I am a partner. I say, you are not a partner, you are a helper. But tell it to people in our time, in our age, I am a helper, I'll show you with a helper. And they start all power struggle. So our Torah do not believe in power struggle, do not believe in ego trips. This is what makes Nadav Avihu, the top people of Am Yisrael, to be dead in the happiest day of Am Yisrael. Because if, God forbid, there is a temple, and there is God, and there is connection, but human beings start to become crazy, and acting as they want to act, it's a waste of time. Nothing will come out of this. Now, we'll come to conclude the point. So, basically, the death of the two brothers and the fire from heaven will bring us the power of Rosh Chodesh Nisan. It's not just everything is good. To be connected is very good. But to be connected is very, it's not just scary, it's very, it's you're obligated to a certain thing. So, you want to be considered a religious Jew, the Torah will give you, as the Zohar Kadosh says in our parasha, the best medication in the world, spiritually, mentally. But the Torah will demand from you to remember that you are a soldier. So, Baruch Hashem, we started the summer session. I would like to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to have a very meaningful and powerful and healthy and strong summer Be'ezrat Hashem. And I think the weather doesn't want this. Winter doesn't want to leave. We're saying fellow love is America. But he has no choice. We say in Hebrew, Mashal Oseh HaSechel Oseh HaZman, the time. The only thing that I would like to tell you as a halachically point, there is mitzvah to say in Birkat HaIlanot, on the flowers on Nisan. In Israel they did it because the summer was, the spring came on time. Today I was checking, most of the trees are not giving flowers yet. So the rabbi of today say that it's not necessarily Nisan. You can wait in Iyar, but it has to see the tree, the two trees of fruits tree, they start to blossom before they give the fruits. Mm-hmm. Today I go with the rabbanit, I went and I saw for places, they just start now. If we can do it by Wednesday before Rosh Chodesh Iyar, we will try to do it, but if not, we can do it in Iyar too. It's not. What the Torah says, the Gemara, in Nisan, it means in the right time. This is the הכרעת הפוסקים. שיהיה לנו שבוע טוב, בשורות טובות, ברוך הנה לעולם. ובי שם,